So let's move to the last two topics of networked embedded system, that is network-based design and internet-enabled systems. So the first topic is network-based design. So in this section, we mainly concentrate on design tasks that are unique to network-based distributed embedded systems. That is things that should be considered while designing a network-based embedded system. Okay, so what are the things to be considered while designing a network-based embedded system? So first one is to analyze the performance of a network, we must know how to determine the delay incurred by transmitting a message. Okay, so first of all, we have to determine the delay for transmitting a message. So for that, assume that messages are sent reliably, that is no retransmission of message occur in the system. Okay, so assume that message delay for a single message with no retransmission. Okay, then the message delay for a single message can be modeled as message delay means the time from sending the message to reach the message at destination, that is called message delay. Okay, so message delay for a single message with no retransmission, that is given as TM equal to TX plus TN plus TR. So here it is given TM equal to TX plus TN plus TR, where TX is the transmitter side overhead and TR is the receiver side overhead. Okay, TX is transmitter side overhead and TR is receiver side overhead, and TN is the network transmission time. TN is network transmission time. Okay, and we can see that this transmitter side overhead and receiver side overhead is negligible in I2C network or I2C bus. Now, if messages can interfere with each other, then analyzing communication delay becomes difficult. In this case, we can write the message delay equation as TY equal to TD plus TM. So what is TD? TD is the network availability delay. That is, network availability delay means waiting for the network to become available. It is difficult to calculate. It is difficult to calculate this delay as it depends on the type of bus arbitration used in the network. Okay, so TD is the network availability delay, that is the waiting time for a network to become available, that is called network availability time. And this one depends upon the bus arbitration technique used in the network. So we know that there are mainly two bus arbitration techniques we have discussed already. First one is fixed bus arbitration and second one is fair bus arbitration technique. Okay, so in fixed bus arbitration technique, the network delay is unbounded for all but the highest priority device. That is, the highest priority device always gets the network first. Okay, in fixed bus arbitration scheme, the highest priority node always get the channel or always get the bus to transfer the message. So the time network delay is unbounded. We can say that the network delay is unbounded for all but the highest priority device. Then second one is fair arbitration. In fair arbitration, delay is bounded. Okay. So we can bound the delay for transmitting a message by each and every node in the network. So example for a fair arbitration technique is round robin arbitration. So consider a round robin arbitration with n devices. Okay, then the worst case network availability delay is given as n into tx plus tr, where n is the number of devices. Then what is TR? TR is the delay for arbitration. Okay, so this TR is a very small value, so we can omit that value if you want. So if we add acknowledgement and data corruption into the analysis, the network delay calculation becomes more difficult. Okay. So in the first case we considered message transmission with no retransmission. Second case we considered messages that interferes with each other, the delay for that messages. Then if we add acknowledgement and data corruption into the analysis along with this message sending, then network delay calculation becomes more difficult. Okay, so the first thing to be considered in the network based design is determine the delay for transmitting a message. So this delay determination or delay calculation is a very difficult job. Then what is the second thing to be considered while designing a network for embedded system? So in a distributed system, a process can be interrupted to execute another process. But in networked embedded system, the messages are sent as packets. So it should be noted that low priority tasks that started their packet transfer should not be interrupted. As a result, network exhibits priority inversion. So in a network based embedded system, we have to design such a network for priority inversion in mind, because the low priority task that started their packet transfer should not be interrupted by a high priority task. Then what is the third reason or third design consideration? We know that the network can be a single hop network or multi hop network. So multi hop network, what is multi hop network? So here you can see a multi hop network in this figure. So here the message from M1 to M5 is routed through M3. Analyzing delay through multi hop network is also very difficult. Okay, so we can design single hop network or multi hop network for an embedded system, but analyzing a multi hop network is more difficult than a single hop network. Then what is the fourth thing? Fourth thing is scheduling and allocation of computations and communications are clearly interrelated. Okay, so scheduling and allocation of computation, these two things are interrelated things. So care should be given if we change the allocation of computation. Okay, so if we change the allocation of computation, that will affect the scheduling. So it should be very care should be given in that case. So that's about network based design. So network based design means what are the things to be considered while designing a network based embedded system. Moving to the next topic, internet enabled systems. So internet protocol or IP is the fundamental protocol on the internet, and it provides connectionless packet based communication, right? So you know all these things, you have studied all these things in networks, right? So IP is the internet protocol, and it's a connectionless packet based protocol or packet based communication it provides. Now example applications are for example an internet based embedded system as in industrial automation, information appliances, etc. Okay, so internet based embedded systems are used in industrial automation, information appliances, etc. In those areas we use this internet based embedded systems. Now IP is an inter networking standard, that is IP packets are assumed to be carried by some other network such as an Ethernet. That is IP packets traverse through several type of networks from source to destination. So it's called an inter networking standard. Now the relation between IP and other network is shown in figure. Okay, so here in this figure the relation between IP and other network is shown. So here you can see IP works at the network layer. Okay, so here IP works at this network layer. When node A wants to send data to node B, the application's data pass through several protocol layers and send to the IP. IP creates packets for routing the message to the destination. A router is a node that transmits data among different types of networks. And a router goes only up to the IP layer or network layer, and no need to go beyond that. It's not required. At the destination, the IP layer, that is the network layer, it provides data to the transport layer and then to the receiving application. Okay, so network layer. So the information flow is like this. Now this figure shows the format of a IP packet. Okay, so this thing you have already studied in computer networks, so I am not giving any explanation for this. Now moving to the different versions of IP, mainly IP has two versions. One is IPv4 and one is IPv6. IPv4 is 32-bit and IPv6 is 128-bit address. So it is usually used to identify a device uniquely identify a device in a network. This IP address is used, and we represent we can represent IPv4 address in dotted decimal notation and IPv6 address in hexadecimal notation. Now we usually refer an internet node by specifying its name, because it's easier for a as a user, it's easier to refer or identify an internet node by specifying its symbolic name rather than its IP address. So for example, www.abc.com. okay, so suppose that is the name of a internet node. So a domain name server will convert the symbolic name to corresponding IP address. So the function of a domain name server is it converts the symbolic name provided by the user to corresponding IP address. Now let's see what is a best effort routing. IP does not guarantee that a packet is delivered to its destination. Okay, and furthermore, packets that may come out of order. This is referred as best effort routing. Okay, so in IP there is no guarantee that packet is delivered to its destination and in correct order. Okay, there is no guarantee. So this is referred as best effort routing. And in an internet enabled embedded system or in general, the performance of IP can be hard to predict. So here this figure shows the relationship between IP and higher level internet services. Okay, so the internet also provides higher level services built on top of IP. Okay, for one example is TCP. So here this figure shows the relationship between IP and higher level internet services. So using IP as the foundation, TCP is used to provide file transfer protocol for batch file transfer. HTTP, that is, you know, hypertext transfer protocol for worldwide web services. SMTP. SMTP is simple mail transfer protocol for email, and Telnet for virtual terminals. So using IP as the foundation, TCP provides all these services. And using IP as the foundation, UDP. UDP is user datagram protocol. It provides network management services, provide like simple network management protocol SNMP. Okay, so using IP as the foundation, TCP and UDP provide different services to the user. Okay. So that's all about internet enabled systems. Thank you.